have to cuff with her, and we're gonna have Alice come up and share about her.
Cora is an awesome woman, and when we first met, it's so funny how I was actually supposed to be in Kids Kingdom that day, but Montserrat actually met her when they were tagging, and so Cora came out and she was praying. She was like, God, if I should go to this church today, wake me up on time, and don't let me go back to sleep, just let me get there on time, and God woke her up on time. She tried to go back to sleep, but could not go back to sleep. So she gets dressed and she comes to church. And they asked me to do Kids Kingdom that day. And Matt Lovechev, he prayed about me. He was like, no, I think you should stay in service. And 2 minutes later, I sat down in my seat and I just looked to my left and she's just standing at leaning on the pole. And so I woke her and I asked her for a chair. Asked her if she wanted a chair. And so I go back to my seat and I know she didn't have a Bible. So I'm like, you can share with me. And so we start going over the scriptures, and I think that day we're doing a persecution study. And so she was just like, well, you know, what's your life in, like, what's your life in your doctrine? And just asking so many questions. And I'm like, hey, man, God. I got really excited. So then after that, we start talking, and then she was like, I want to study the Bible. And so we just studied that day.
Awesome.
And we've just been studying ever since. And
awesome.
Last quick thing, we right before the light and the darkness study, Cora said, she sit down, and it was me and Nishay sitting there, and before we even opened the Bible or did anything, before she even knew that the name was Light and Darkness, she's like, God, she just got completely open. And she was like, I'm tired of being in the dark, I just want to be in the light.
Wow.
And I was like, I just got chills, and me and Nishay was like, that's the name of the city, the Light and Darkness. But Cora is an awesome one, awesome young lady, and I just want to tell you that if you just stay close to God and you remain fast in Him and you keep searching for Him like you've been searching for Him, and you keep His word close to you, you will be blessed with wisdom and
that's
God's love.
Yes. Come on. Amen. Come on, Cora.
I just want to say that I'm the type of person that always puts things off. You know, I'm the biggest procrastinator. I knew Jesus, but I didn't know Him as well as I needed to. And I wanted to, I just didn't know how. And I didn't kind of want to know how because of my friends and everyone who I'm around, everyone that influences me.
Yep.
I didn't really care. And I'm so blessed to know these ladies. There were times where I was pushing them away, and I was telling them this is too much, and I can't take it. But they assured me that it's okay, and that I'm not alone. And all I had to do was pray. And they taught me everything that I needed to know. And I'm just so grateful, and I just can't wait to be an example to other ladies.
So, as a privilege of asking you to support the
come on. What did you say?
Handles.
Do you believe that Jesus is the Son of God, and He died on the cross for your sins and was risen on the third day?
Yes,
it was a good confession, man.
That Jesus is Lord!
Awesome.
walks in her walk, strength five. And I heard her. I ask that we are asked of them to become a generation of yes. I ask that we all be with her, keep her in our kingdom world, and that she is strong and a woman. Thank you,
Father. Amen. Ready? One, two, three.